Sung by both Union and Confederate soldiers.
Why would they sing the same song?
Because the Civil War pitted race against race, family against family, and friend against friend. They sang the same songs because they all felt the same, homesick and afraid. You'll see, it was a war of terrible violence and sadness. Just listen.
Thank you. Ventured outside to look around. She wore her hair in a huge waterfall at the back of her head. That was the fashion then, and a cannonball had passed so close behind her head that the wind from it tore her hair down and left it streaming. It was strange that our house was untouched through it all.
I remember seeing the stewardess screaming past from Delhi until afternoon. They were galloping this way, and then I wondered what it was all about. When the battle was nearing its close, the Confederates took our house from our hospital, and the floors were covered. While the surgeons were, Mother boiled water and washed the wounds and held them.
I remember one man who was terribly wounded in the face. Our house was so full, he could not come in, and he sat on the curb of the cistern. I drew water, washed his wounds, and he got up and walked away. As the Confederates retreated, a young man came in and took his brother away. The surgeons said he must not be moved, but the brother insisted. He said he would not leave them there to be killed by the Yankees. He put him on his horse in front of him, but they went off only a little way when the soldier died. Even the slaves were sad to see the man's grief, because they knew how it felt to lose their family.
Thank you.
thought was right. When the Civil War began, she was asked to help the Union Army. She went behind the lines as a scout and a spy. She went to Virginia and worked as a nurse in an army hospital and marched to her. She was never paid for her work, but lived by her wits, buying and selling vegetables, making pies, and brewing root beer to orange tea.
After the war, she moved to Auburn, New York, married a war veteran, and opened a home for elderly black people. She often spoke of her experience. She also spoke for equal rights for women. Though she had never been lucky enough to go to school, she knew the importance of learning. She worked to get schools for the newly freed blacks.
The Queen of England, Queen Victoria, heard of Harriet Tubman and wrote her a letter inviting her to come to England for a visit. Harriet didn't have the money to go. Maybe it didn't matter. She became more famous than some of the people who curtsied to the Queen. Few people in American history have had the courage and determination of Harriet Tubman. Now, do you know why she was called Moses?
Did all slaves make it to freedom?
We'll never know. The Underground Railroad, so secret, especially in Missouri, that many slaves disappeared, either north to free states in Canada, or they lost their lives trying to get there. I fought on the Confederate side, but I never believed in slavery. That was the irony of the war. Many of us fought just because we were Southerners, not to hold on to slavery. And many of our friends were conscripted into the Union Army, like Mr. Warnell, who watched the Battle of Westport take place on the edge of his own farm.
Did your family fight for the Union in the Battle of Westport?
Yes, my own siblings. My father and I followed General Sterling Price out of Arkansas. My brother and my sister enlisted in the Union Army because they believed President Lincoln could end the war and abolish slavery at the same time.
Your sister? How could your sister enlist?
Yeah, I didn't think girls were allowed to fight.
It breaks my heart to tell you this, but my sister cut her hair and dressed like a boy so she could follow her husband. You'd be surprised to find out how many women did that.
What was the battle like?
Like many battles, it started with tired, hungry soldiers gathered around a campfire, singing to pass the time away. If you look carefully, you can see me there, griping about the food, or lack of it, as usual. There I am, see, but we didn't have long to gripe that day.
Teeth colored, no, force hives.
Give me now, one gentle autumn, before the dying of the year. Give me one field of unbloodied grass, while I can still see far. Now you know my story. Do you believe me now that the war was terrible?
Yes, we believe you.
Why are you still here?
Yeah, can you rest now?
I can rest when I know that you'll never let a situation ever happen in America again. You must never let one race dominate another. You must never settle your differences with fighting. The future is yours now. The country is yours. Which way will you go?
Treat the poor and run for the child that needs a friend. Thank you, children. Thank you, audience. And just a couple special thank yous. Mom came through last night. That's Mom Hamilton, Faith's mother, sitting on the stool with her. And she dropped the whole score a key, I guess, an octave. Or they thought I was going to sing something, so they knew they had to get it lowered. Thank you. And Ms. Trent, we want to thank you for this wonderful new rendition. Those of you who had siblings participate in our old version of the Civil War, we've come of age, putting things right in Kansas City. We're very proud of that. And I know you all know how lucky we are to have someone like Mrs. Trent who can do the kinds of things she does with the music and the words and the songs. She had a great group of kids to do that with and a great group of teachers. And I want to single out that group too. Mrs. Ashley, would you stand, please? Thank you for all your hard work. As luck would have it, the day she was shooting pictures of the Westport battlefield, we got the cooperation of the fog on the ground to make it look a little more realistic. And also, we'd like to thank Mrs. Swender. Would you stand, please? For a bit of history, our new teacher on the staff also was a student of Mrs. Trent's at Barstow School in 1978, Mr. Carolyn. And two important people that are not here this evening, but our assistants, Mrs. Poe and Mrs. McWilliams, were also an important part of this program, and also several parents. I know Kathleen Brown finishes out a string of about 6 years where she's helped with this play. Ms. Brown, would you please stand? And to all the wonderful parents who've supported us and will continue, and Mr. Titus is doing the filming of this. So if any of you need your personal professional version, you can get that very easily through him. And we want to thank our students one more time with a nice round of applause. And we'd like for you to join us on the part of the Arts Council to a reception in the lobby.